It's live.
Thank you for your patience.
All right.
Thank you.
Yep, bye.
All right, so, again, we'll keep this short and sweet. I know weekends are busy for people, so I'll just speak a little bit. I'll take it over to the JV coaches. They can hand out their awards. I'll then hand out the varsity, and we'll be good to go. So the first thing I really want to say is thank you to everyone. I mean, the players for their constant hard work and dedication, and then also having to deal with wearing a mask while playing volleyball. I mean, I played a little bit with you during practice, and I can't even imagine a whole game having a mask on. So thank you for accommodating and being flexible with the changes that you had to make this season happen. I also want to thank the parents for their support and their patience as we navigated this the fluid season, because it honestly was changing every day. The team we were playing, the times we were playing, you know, just the parents, you know, thank you for just going with the flow, pretty much, because we all kind of had to do that this year. I want to thank the JV coaches for stepping up and making an awesome JV team. They had a great season. And so thank you for stepping up and helping us this season. We truly appreciate it. And then also the administration, Marsha, for making this season happen. Without you, it wouldn't have. And I'm pretty sure you were probably running around with your head cut off, like more than once a day, trying to keep this season going. So again, I just want to make sure that I see your hard work, and I want to thank you from, again, the players, the parents, the coaches, and the administration, because without everyone, this wouldn't have happened, especially in this year. So that's what I want to say. What an amazing season we all had. You know, from wondering if it was ever going to start, to going 6-1 on the varsity side, in the regular season, and then making it all the way to the regional finals. We had a great season. We played hard. We worked hard in our practices, and we had fun. And to have fun and yet be good at the same time, or to be successful at the same time, you need that component of effort, because without that effort, that discipline, the fun isn't going to last, because the fun, because you won't see the outcome, that successful outcome. You know, so it really goes to show you how hard you guys worked, but at the same time, incorporating that sense of fun into the game. And that combination of effort and fun is so important. With having the great season, I will be honest, prior to the season, as the schedule started to come out, as Marsha gave me the updates of the season, I started to cringe. I was like, how am I going to coach this season? For two reasons. One, the time, or the lack of time that we had, from having 8 or 9 short practices before our first match to having a game every other day. You know, there's, as coaches, there's more to our role for you guys than to just put drills together and let you guys play for 2 hours. Our role is in that preseason, in those 9 days, we were finding the chemistry on what players worked well together, where players were going to end up being on the court. And then also, you know, it's more than prepping you guys for the next opponent. It's more than just giving you repetitions. It's helping you understand the game, the strategies behind the game. You know, understanding that being powerful in the game of volleyball is fun, but there's so much more to the game than power, and that's strategy. And so to weave that into such a busy schedule, you know, I wasn't sure if it was gonna happen, but we made it happen. Because again, that effort that you guys put into it, you helped the coaches by your willingness to wear the masks and listen and just do what we asked you in practice. You were able to help make the season secondly is, I knew you guys were gonna get exhausted with that schedule. I think we all got exhausted with that schedule, coaches as well. You know, those last few weeks, you know, but we pulled it out and we kept pushing and we kept going at it because that's what we wanted to do. That's where that dedication to the program comes in. And that's where, like last year, I talked about what builds a successful program, and it's dedication. It's not the talent per se that helps, but it's about the dedication to you guys, to the program. And you guys just showed it beautifully this season. So let me get back to my spot here because I kind of went off script as I knew I would. But we made the schedule work. You guys kept an open mind, especially on the varsity team. A lot of you, I was putting you in different positions because I kept saying, tomorrow, next week, we have no idea what our team may look like. So you guys stayed open-minded and were willing to try new positions for the betterment of the team in the future if we had to make those changes. And literally, we could put any lineup on that floor and we would win. And that is awesome. That goes to show, again, that effort and that open-mindedness that all of you guys had to this program. And again, so that's how we are building this strong and dedicated program. So it all comes back to you guys again. So thank you so much. Again, I'm gonna try and keep this short for all of you. Just a few quick things. Again, so the next few things I want you to keep in mind. Again, this will all be COVID dependent. Just talking about, you know, coming spring and next summer, just some things for you to be aware of. Again, depending on what it looks like, maybe throwing in some springtime open gyms for volleyball. For those of you guys that want some, I do have an off-season program, weight training program in the platform app for you guys. And freshmen, I will get you guys logged in and have you, if you don't have access to it yet, I'll make sure you guys have access. It's about a 3-month program. So ideally getting it in at least once or two times before next season would be great because there's a lot of jump training, there's a lot of core work, there's a lot of strength that'll really help develop your practice or develop your game come August. It seems so far away, but it's going to come so fast. We are hopefully having the summer league again, so Monday nights come June and July, right? Mm-hmm. Hopefully those will be going on, so you guys will be able to play then. And also plan the second to last week of July having that skills camp as well, and hopefully again it won't be virtual. That was a little difficult to teach you skills when you don't have a ball to work with or a teammate to play with. So just keep those in mind. And with that, I will give it to the JV coaches and we will get started with the awards.
Hello, welcome. Thank you so much, athletes, for being here. Thank you, parents, for appearing here virtually. So it was a short season, right? It was a very unique season given COVID pandemic, but you are all very resilient, and you all stayed really, really focused on the season, and that's what made this season very successful for us, so thank you. Coach Mark and I want to thank the parents for raising such wonderful, gifted, strong, amazing young ladies. We want to thank you, athletes, for being patient with us and for trusting and believing in us as your volleyball mentors this season. Coach Mark and I decided to do things a little differently this season and not give out special individual awards, but rather, JV, please stand up where you are seated. Stand. Take a look around, ladies. Look at your fellow teammates. Look to the varsity team. This is your volleyball family. Appreciate one another. Respect one another. Support each other. And be happy for each and every one that is part of this team and made this season possible. season was not about counting the wins or the losses. This season was about building the characteristics and charisma of leaders and true champions in life, both on and off the court. Congratulations, ladies, you did it. Great job. So without further ado, let's put our hands together and congratulate the entire JV team for being recognized for Dodgeland 2020 Junior Varsity Season MVP, Most Improved Player, and Heart of the Team Award. Congratulations, we are very proud of you. So we will now individually call your names out, and you can come up and receive your individual season letter award. Avery Koppenstein.
For it to heal, but while it was healing, you were there each and every day. You were there, you were helping out when you could, and yet when you were ready to come back, you were wanting to just come in whenever, wherever I was putting you. And that passion really showed through, even with an injury. So I do want to thank you for that, and it was a joy having you. I know sometimes when you were scoring, it was a little confusing, and I'm always the best at explaining things that way. But and I definitely look forward to having you next year. We almost got you to scream in that one practice. we'll work on it next year though. But your hustle was loud. You were going to the floor for balls. You were getting after balls. And I don't know how many saves you had, but your hustle really helped our defensive part of the game. So I do want to know that I saw that and your willingness to say hi to the floor more times than most volleyball players want to. So I want to say thank you for your defensive skills and your smile and just your personality on and off the court. It's just very, it's very compassionate. So Alexis, if you will come on up. And you on in the center, and lo and behold, you became our libero. Are you going to add hitting next year? Because we're losing some hitters this season, so maybe you can add that onto your repertoire too. But honestly, you stepped into the libero position, maybe a little wide-eyed at first, but you took the reins and you took control and you made it your position. And it was fun watching you, and again, with defense, the hustle, and everything that you provided for us in that back row, from serving consistency to the serve receive, and even in the back row attacks, to know that you had that consistency that really helps a team to know, like, hey, if we are in a jam, we can throw it up and Kira can get it over the net. So I want to thank you for your consistency and versatility on the court. So not only do I want to congratulate you for second team all conference, but you also have the most improved award as well. Volleyball player, and by far you're one of our strongest and most consistent servers. So thank you for helping us have such a successful season, and I look forward to having you back next season. Morgan was one of our captains this year. She also got honorable mention for our all-conference team, so congratulations with that. And I want to say that you have, from last year to this year, you have developed into such a strong player. Even your cheers have strength behind them. Like you're like that Hulk out there. It's so fun to watch you. But you're always looking to improve yourself. But I think there's more to it. Where, like, yes, you individually want to improve for yourself, but I think you also want to do it for the better of the team. You know, so you have that focus to yourself, but you also are doing it for the program at the same time. And I see that, and I appreciate that, because many times we can get a little bit too honed in on, you know, what's best for me. And to see that we do have players that, you know, do play for the betterment of everybody is just, it's heartwarming. Your energy and your spirit brings and keeps everyone together, and that is why that is why you are an honorable mention, and that is why you are the heart of our team as well. So come on over. Congratulations, first team all conference. That's awesome. And it just goes to show you what a great setter you are. I mean, you are a hustler, you get the ball up, and you allow our hitters to look good, you know? So, where's my spot again? So you're a teammate that has the experience that when we are in those tough situations, that you are staying even keel. Like, you've been there, and so you can really help these other girls that maybe just play volleyball in the high school season. You can keep them even keel too, by they can just see your attitude and your energy, and you really help them, you know, not get too excited or not get too down. We're able to look at you to have that kind of that calm center. So again, and I think that's another reason why you did make that first team all conference this year. I also noticed how you stayed after practice and helped the younger setters really develop. So I see your passion and I see your love of the game. You know, there is so much more to volleyball than just the skill, and that's where it starts to come off the court, and to see that you're helping the program by helping the younger kids. So we definitely want to thank you for that here as well. So congratulations, Emily, and we don't have any of the conference medals or certificates yet. They're still coming. So when they are here, I'm sure you'll be able to pick them up in the MVP too will be, the plaque will be coming as well. Okay. So I'm going to combine Lily and Allie. Neither one of these girls are here, but I do want to say, by far our biggest cheerleaders. You know, we are amazing, right? But I want you guys, the JV coaches, they talked on this a little bit too, but I want to say, like, when I say everyone on this team is equal, everyone's role on this team is important to our success. I mean it. Whether you are a starter, whether you play part-time, or you are on the sidelines, you do have an integral part to this team. And I believe that Allie and Lily were definitely, they definitely possessed that mindset of, you know, it doesn't matter if you're on the court or off the court, I'm here for the team and I'm supporting you. And I want you guys to remember that, because even in life, whether you are on top or in the middle or still, you know, at the bottom working your way up, you're always an integral part of whatever you're doing in your life. And so to keep that mindset, to keep that in the back of your mind, luck to all of your endeavors and never lose that positivity. And if you keep that mindset, you can make anything happen, because the coaches or the bosses that you may have will see that leadership and promote you or and just you'll just make great things happen if you can keep that mindset and seeing everyone equal, and everybody just has a different role to play, and it may change throughout the season as well or throughout a career. And then Emma, she is not here as well, but again, congratulate her. Again, she made the team all conference. I want to say your talent and strength as an outside hitter is visible to everyone. You are in your elements on the court, and you just look natural on the volleyball court. Your strength and consistency helped us pull through some of the tougher matches that we had this season. And again, you're one of our teammates that had a little bit more experience. So again, somebody that really we could look to in those tougher times to help keep that even keel that we need to stay focused on the court. So I want to say many wishes for you and your volleyball career. You're going to do great, and I wish you all the luck. Congratulate her on that, and I just want to say with Bria, your energy and your commitment is contagious. You know, I really saw a maturity happen between last season and this season that really brought out that leader in you on and off the court. You know, you, like I said, your energy is consistent. So being able, when you were on the court, similar to Emily and Emma, you were there. You were positive, and you didn't let the ups and downs really bother you too much. So that leadership, again, really helped the more developing players see how to react in those situations as well. You know, whether it was five points down in a game, I believe that whether it's 5 points down in a game or if we were all lost in a forest, I think we would trust you to kind of get us out of it. You just have that that demeanor, that confidence that we all had a trust in you to lead us in the correct way. So it was a pleasure being your coach these last 2 years, and I see great things for you. So keep being you, and I will see you around. Throughout the entire season. Let's keep our fingers crossed that next season is back to normal. I do understand that a handful of you are playing club ball, and I would love to see I'd like to stay in touch and see how that is going. So if you do want to connect on social media, that would be fun. I'd like to see your journey through club ball and see how you're doing. So feel free to find me on Facebook or Instagram. My handle is just Katie Schleep or Katie Glidden. Pretty easy to find. If not, no worries, I'm not going to put it against you. But it would just be fun to watch you guys progress through.